suppose we were to look at the various challenges as opportunities. And you know how you develop an agile mindset? You don't waste any crisis. You don't waste any opportunity. You embrace them. And just recognizing that the good thing with life is that it's dynamic and you know say it's gonna change.
Balance is not something you find. We all love to say, find a balance in life. You can't find it. You have to actively create it. It takes the mind to tell your body exactly what to do.
There is a saying in North American business culture, right? That irrespective of whatever he or she says or does, the organization is a reflection of the chief executive.
Well said.
Full stop. Right? Full stop. And so, when things go right, I am responsible. When they go wrong, I am responsible. I might even know about it, but I am responsible. You know why? Because I have the power to change it.
And having gotten a chance to really speak to their team members, having gotten a chance to speak to their colleagues and their co-workers in other areas of their respective departments, everybody has the same things to say about all of them, which I thought was kind of crazy.
Everybody says, Shana, why you love chatty business so much? Because I feel that if most of us would share with each other, we could learn from each other. So many of us go through things, come out better, stronger, bigger. Why can't we share our journey and how we got there so somebody else can benefit?
So I need everybody to stand for me. We're gonna get back in our bodies a little bit, right? I've never done this before, so let's just work with me, all right? So just start by just moving your body a little bit. Stretch if you have to. Just move funny, whatever you need to do, just, yeah. Hopefully I don't emerge right here.
0.6 million of population. Not even a percent of a percent of the world's population in total, 7 billion people. Yet, when you talk about Brand Jamaica, we don't just make a blimp, we make a splash.
Many of the things that I experienced in the sporting field prepared me for life as it is now for me.
Planning is essential. You should always have a plan. Just know that life will happen, it will step in. The question is, how will you handle it? What will you do?
It eventually came. Not because I thought that that was what's gonna happen, but because I allowed God to guide my path. I went for it. I couldn't handle going all over the place anymore, and I eventually created a space called Chai Studios. That's where everybody could come to me and start getting their classes versus me picking up myself and running all over the place.
So you have to learn to forgive those people who bring the hate to you and show them love and love them, love them, love them all. When they may hate you, not stop, love them, right? Because there's a God that's taking care of everything else.
And the truth is that, you know what, guys? I suffer with imposter syndrome, as I'm sure. Anybody in here know what that is? So imposter syndrome is where you feel like you're almost faking it. Like people are gonna figure out that you don't know what the heck you are doing, right? So this started a very long time for me, even from when I was a kid. And you know, recently I had to go into the root of what that was, but we'll talk about that.
Now, one of the things that is important about leadership, right? Is authenticity. You can't impose a certain level of requirements or expectation on people and don't hold yourself to the same standard.
Hey, as a university student abroad myself, what were some of your deciding factors to come home, even though you've mentioned how much you love home?
I believe there has to be an opportunity that you take about taking the most that you can get from the experience where you are in college or where are traveling, because it is what prepares you. But I think because I shared earlier about living for a cause greater than yourself, I think you need to find the thing that you can contribute the greatest. And it might mean not coming back immediately, but at one point in your time, you will come back and contribute.
I have made so many mistakes in my life. And you know what? Today we find all kind of fancy names to call them. We call them blessings. We call them lessons. But when it was happening, they were mistakes. They were an error in judgment that we weren't prepared for or that we didn't know how to deal with in the moment. Would you agree?
be selfish. For me to get to where I was going, I realized I had to be a little selfish. In order to be selfless, you have to be a little selfish, because if you have nothing left in you to give, what you gonna give?
So something that's interesting is even when I used to sing, I used to go on that stage every time and be like, they might go figure out something I know for that something, you know. And they might go figure out something I can't really sing neither, so I better pop two joke and whine, right? when I started Blow by Blow, the salon, they're gonna figure out that I never went to business school. I never even went to hair school. What the heck am I doing? Like starting a business, what?
Failure is okay. That's okay, right? You know, the only time you don't fail is if you don't do anything, right? So you're going to fail. And I tell people all the while that people will fail. Nothing is wrong with failure, but you have to accept responsibility.
What is the importance of a father in shaping their child's life? And I'm sure it might be, you know, different for a daughter or a son.
I'm responsible for making sure that she understands what boundaries are. I think I'm also, as the primary male influence in her life, responsible for helping her to understand how to relate to boys and men, perhaps at a later date.
I'm changing every day as a mom. How I used to parent, you know, even 5 years ago versus now is completely different. And I think my children have really forced me into understanding the power of now, being here now, and what that really means.
By the way, I don't know how I could escape my forehead because my last name is Rocket. It's almost impossible. The rocket had to be represented somewhere, right? But I was able to convince myself when I was younger that the reason why my forehead is so big is because I have more brain than everybody else and I'm smarter. So I made my flaw my gift.
We believe that the biggest investment you can make is in yourself. And so we go to a lot of these things, but what we find is we go to a lot of events. In the moment, we feel great, we feel charged, we feel ready to go. And we get back home and a week passes, 2 weeks passes, you're back on Instagram and you're looking at everybody living their hashtag best life except you. And so you feel stuck. And we wanted to create a summit and workshops that would allow you to not just feel good in the moment, but you actually leave with actionable next steps to continue living this best life in the real way and the best way possible for you. And that's how Emerge was really born. So we really want to ensure that when you leave here today, you don't just leave here feeling good, but you continue feeling good and you're actually taking the next steps to be better at whatever it is that you're trying to do or whatever you're trying to achieve.